Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. On the SGI graph with earthquakes magnitude 5.5 and larger, we see an obvious cluster on the 20th and 21st that's just following the near quadruple conjunction that we had around the 19th, 20th that I discussed in detail in a previous update. We anticipated potential major seismic activity. That did not happen, but we see this obvious cluster here on the 20th and the 21st. It peaked magnitude 6 in Taiwan. It could have been bigger, definitely, but this really depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust, what the actual seismic response is going to be. So an obvious cluster on the 20th and the 21st, following the critical planetary and lunar geometry on the 18th and 19th in particular. And also, on the 23rd, 24th, and 25th, we had critical planetary geometry convergence, several planetary conjunctions there, and we see a seismic response there, 5.7, 5.6, around that magnitude. Stronger seismic activity, but not really the anticipated larger seismic activity. And if you look at this SSGI graph carefully, we actually see that from the 16th to the 19th, there was not a single stronger earthquake, nothing with magnitude 5.5 and larger. This is very interesting. It happened in the second half of the time frame with it following the critical geometry. Also, the lunar conjunction with Jupiter on the 25th so far has not resulted in a larger seismic event as I anticipated. If we look at the next SGI graph, also for the coming time frame, we see some seismic activity already there. 5.6 at the Fox Islands, Aleutian Islands. That was actually the seismic response that we had following the lunar conjunction with Jupiter. That was later on the 26th. And also early today, this morning, we had a 5.7 and 5.8 magnitude earthquake. It happened in the South Pacific at the Southeast Lotu Islands region and also the Kermadec Islands region 5.8. And it happened at the time of the lunar conjunction with Mars. If we look at this SGI graph, what we see is a convergence of planetary lunar geometry in two cases. That will be tomorrow on the 29th. That will be the new moon, and it will converge with semi-right angle geometry involving Venus, Mercury, and Uranus. That's the more critical geometry. Remember, last week we had it with Neptune. And as I said, with Uranus, it's usually a bit more critical. And there could be a seismic response there around the 31st, as earliest, in my opinion. And then we see the lunar peaks with Saturn and Neptune, and also with Venus, on the 1st of February, and that converges with Earth in a conjunction with Venus and Neptune. That will be in the afternoon of the 1st of February. And that means that with the planetary conjunction Earth, Venus, Neptune, the Moon will be in a conjunction with both planets, Venus and Neptune, within 24 hours. And that is a recipe for a potential magnitude 7 earthquake, a major seismic event. And that could be earliest on the 2nd, but probably around the 3rd of February. That's really the critical seismic, the critical planetary lunar geometry that we have in the coming time frame up until the 4th of February. Not many planetary conjunctions, but again, around the 29th, on the 29th, we have a convergence of some planetary lunar geometry, and also on the 1st of February. That's actually what we're going to have in the coming time frame. Check out the website for the latest updates, especially atmospheric anomalies. We update it on the website and also in social media. This is the update for now. Stay safe. Until next time.